This is Which Space News for Friday the 9th of October 2020. I'm Commander Buur. In this week's news, the latest CG is live and there are megaships firing in the combat zones. We've got yet more answers from Frontier about the features of Odyssey. And after a significant format change there's a new edition of Sagittarius Eye. If you enjoy this video remember to hit the thumbs up and subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any of our future updates. The latest in the ongoing torrent of community goals in the game went live on Thursday, continuing the current struggle between the Empire and the political ideologies of Marlinism. The Empire, having failed to take the engineer Liz Ryder into custody last week, has now turned its eye towards the Aquada system where it believes the faction known as the Dudu Sekhless Empire League rolls off the tongue have been recruiting its population into the Neo-Marlinist Liberation Army or NMLA, an extremist paramilitary organisation that claimed responsibility for the attacks on starports in Imperial space a few weeks back. As was the case last week, community goals have sprung up in the Aquada system with two CGs vying for independent pilots' attention and firepower. One fighting for the Imperial authorities, the other fighting for the Marlinist refugees who are attempting to flee the conflict and persecution by the Imperials in a number of megaships. The particularly interesting thing about this CG and its resultant combat zones is that the megaships being used in the evacuation are actually showing up in the combat zones and participating in the ensuing firefight. Frontier promised some significant time ago that Galnet would only be reporting on things that are actually in the game, doing away with some of the more fluff based colour and texture articles that were never actually in the game but did, some would argue, add some extra depth to the Elite Dangerous experience. True to their word, the megaships referred to in the community goal are present in some of the combat zones and are actively participating in the engagements happening in their airspace. If a ship of the Imperial forces strays close to the megaships or indeed is kited over there by an enthused YouTuber and his camera operator wife then it is actively fired upon. It may seem odd to say this but this isn't really something we've seen in the game before, outside of the odd bug here and there, so to see not only one megaship but in fact three all flying in the same instance and participating in combat happening around them, this is new. The CG is likely to run until Thursday, grab your best gun and go get involved and see the spectacle for yourself. Our thanks to General Zoff on our Discord server who pointed us to the combat zone shown in this report that was around Aquada 7 if you want to go hunting for it. There are of course other schools of thought. Captain James Flint of Flintlock Engineering announced this morning that the Imperial squadron that he serves, Ashling's Angels, which aligns itself to the ideals of Ashling Duval, is calling on all Imperial and independent pilots alike to refrain from participation in the bloodshed surrounding the Empire's actions in Aquada and instead deliver power generators and agronomic treatment to the system and buy gold and silver from the system to help feed the populace and drive trade and wealth production instead. I love it that the community is almost choosing its own path here. Blaze your own trail indeed. Choose your side and pitch in with whatever fits you best. Frontier have delivered some more nuggets of information about Odyssey via the Content Creators Collaboration program that we've been enrolled into. This is in addition to the roundup of what we know so far about Odyssey that we released earlier this week, which is linked on screen just now for you if you haven't seen it already. On the subject of the differences between mission boards and mission giving NPCs, Frontier have said that they may offer you different work and, get this, you may sometimes be actively approached at a settlement and the reward for helping with their task may be greater. So essentially it seems an NPC may actively approach you with a mission. On the subject of engineers, Frontier have confirmed something we've long suspected. A new cast of engineers will be joining the game with the launch of Odyssey. They haven't yet furnished any more details than that but with the suits very much being the spaceships of the Odyssey expansion and having modules all of their own, we think it's a fairly safe bet that at least some of those engineers will be helping to improve the performance of your suits and their modules as well as your personal weapons and equipment etc at the very least. And lastly, one of the rewards for the community goal last week to defend Liz Ryder was a missile rack that had not one but two engineering improvements stacked on it, lightweight and high capacity as well as thermal cascade. Frontier have confirmed that this is a special reward for the CG concerned and it's not to be taken as a sign that dual stacking of engineering modifications is something that will be coming to the game. And finally, the galaxy's favourite magazine Sagittarius Eye, which recently announced that it was evolving into a podcast only format and mothballing its written word arm for the moment whilst simultaneously switching to a regular monthly schedule, has, this week, released its latest episode. The magazine this week delves into two of the galaxy's biggest ongoing mysteries as well as articles about laser weapons and the virtues of the oft overlooked Saud Kruger dolphin. Suffice to say it's linked in the description below. That's it for now. Thanks very much for watching. We'll be back later this week with more videos. Until then, 07 CMDRs, follow the greens on the way out and do keep clear of the toast rack. We very much look forward to seeing you next time.